Hey, Steve Zook, welcome back to Pokesu Channel and the Guitar Live System. Yeah, I had kind of something kind of funny happen this morning related to guitar. I was just cruising around reverb, looking at arch tops and hollow bodies and samcick hollow bodies, and I ran across an ad for, I think, a Jay-Z samcick arch top guitar, which I think are really cool, which is what one of these is. This is like a Jay-Z 2, I do believe. And by the way, Jay-Z 2, Jay-Z 3, Jay-Z 4, the bigger number doesn't mean it's a better guitar. These are undervalued guitars, but I saw one and I looked and I thought, that looks like me, and they were using my demo, but they didn't say in the ad, not actual guitar, which they should have. So I sent them a nice email. I said, hey, why don't you give me a deal on the guitar since you're using my video. But watching the video gave me an idea for a video I could do here, which is on superimposing. Big subject, so I can't dive into it real heavy, but you'll get better at it if you do the guitar ladder system, which you can order at steveszookguitars.com if you really want to take a quantum leap in your understanding of guitar and music and learn about color and tension and resolution and how to move all up and down the neck and in beautiful chord voicings and begin to actually discover your own harmonic preferences, your own harmonic logic, your own, you know, what happens as you learn more about improvisation is that you begin to find things that begin to define your style, even if you're not a pro, it doesn't matter. We do this because we love it. But you'll begin to find things that really define what you like to do. Like I love to use a major 13 flat 5. By the way, I'm actually using my Roland amp for this. A lot of times I use my PV 212 solid state. But anyway, superimposing is when, you know, and I'm going to make a very simplified definition of this so people can kind of begin to grab onto the idea a little bit. Is you know, you're taking, in fact, I actually talked to Alan Holdsworth about this on the phone once. Superimposing is not always being so concerned about the tonal center, you know, thinking, okay, this is this chord, therefore it's in the key of E, or I use an E scale, whatever. You know, trying different types of single note sounds over passages of chords. So, you know, a lot of times that can be a collection of ideas. Your lick can be a combination of different kinds of colors. It could be diminished, augmented, harmonic minor, pentatonic, a combination of those. And sometimes the lick travels to another area of maybe where the progression is going to. So you're not so much worried about tonal centers. Not saying that's not important, by the way. It's good to recognize tonal centers, but you know, your playing can get really predictable and boring if all you're thinking about is, oh, okay, there's that chord, and so that one's in, that's in the key of D, but then it's going to here, which would be the key of E, you know. So that's why it's really good to work on licks and then practice, like recording something simple and then play over it, you know. And so it's good to practice licks that have different kinds of color in them, you know. Like I'll give you some example here. Diminish, you know, my amp is doing some weird stuff. I don't know if it's my cable or my amp. Hope my amp ain't falling apart. Probably my cable, though. So like a diminished lick, here's a diminished arpeggio. So you move that diminished lick down in half steps. I kind of chromaticize. You know, it's funny, certain guitars sound really good in this Roland amp and certain ones don't sound as good, and there's no real rhyme or reason. I think for this guitar, I'm going to switch over to my PV, although some guitars sound unbelievable in that Roland amp. It's a funny thing. You can't really wrap your, there's no hard and fast rules about it, but I just noticed that. I think I'm going to use my PV for this, and not trying to impress anybody with production here, obviously. I don't give a shit what people think. I do a lot of giving on my YouTube channel. I share a lot of free information. So if you're going to leave a comment, leave a nice one. Because if you don't, I'm just going to get rid of it anyway. You don't have to kiss my ass, but don't be an asshole, okay? Send me some positive energy, you know? Anyway, I like these old solid-state PV amps. They really have a nice sound. See, I think it has a lot to do with the 212s. Anyway, so that diminished lick. So the diminished lick arpeggio is 1 flat 3, flat 5, double flat 7, the key is C. Here's my A, by the way. Key is C. But what makes it interesting is you kind of chromaticize it. Maybe do a little sequence, augmented splash like Martino. So you work on separate licks without worrying about what key they're in or where they fit, because music gets interesting when you don't worry about rules and you break rules. Sure, you have to understand basic harmony, you know what the different chords are and what scale is kind of the inside scale, but it gets real boring real quick if that dominates your thinking. So a lick like this is good to work. Then I'll come down to another diminished arpeggio. That, here's my A, by the way, I'm probably not a concert pitch. Take that arpeggio, go into the half step, whole step scale. Sometimes you repeat a little sequence that kind of gives you that Martino feel. But what I'm talking about, here's another that the old Charlie Parker riff. Because I was watching myself do this demo on this Jay-Z samcick, which somebody is using my demo, and so it kind of got me thinking about all this a little bit. So you can do things like that. Charlie Parker riff. And then you can kind of do a little sequence on that. Kind of Borelli LeGrand likes to do it like that. Kind of chromaticize it even more. I use this similar. Maybe go into a diminished arpeggio on the bass string. So my point, and I am simplifying this, so you know, I don't think there's any reason to get real complex about it. You just work on different colors. You work on different colors. For instance, I might go from an augmented riff. You explore as opposed to just practice, you explore. Oh, there's that augmented riff to a pentatonic, minor pentatonic sound. So what I'm talking about is exploring different single note colors without worrying about where they fit. And then maybe record yourself doing a simple, it can be real, you know, just a couple minor seven chords, maybe throw in some seven sharp nines and add a little tension. If you add a little tension to your simple jam, then that kind of gives you a place to play with these different sounds. You know, try using diminished sounds, try using a very intervallic sounding lick like some of the ones I just showed. Maybe do a slight little bit of blues. When things get interesting is when you break the rules. Things get interesting when you kind of color shift, like maybe you go from one color to another color. Maybe, because if you just stay with all your outside licks, you're gonna kind of lose people. But if you're doing, if you just practice licks, so that's why I love that these diminished ideas. I've showed this lick before. I know right now somebody's thinking, can you get closer? Okay. Can never have perfect camera angles here. So the idea is to explore different colors and then practice doing little chord progressions. They can be very, very simple. And so superimposing is more layering other ideas that can have a combination of colors over something else. And I'm doing a very simple definition of it, because I think when people get into complex definitions, they just confuse people. So I mean, I could do like minor seven, you know, A minor seven to B minor seven, and I could just, you know, just play off the G major scale, or I could superimpose, you know, more interesting ideas. So what I'm talking about is, and there's nothing wrong with, you know, learning to play real inside, but work on licks, work on color shifting. So you're going from maybe a diminished idea to a pentatonic idea, major seven. You know, and try to shift around. Like a real colorful lick would be like, and the trick is not to stay in one color too long. Like if I go and then it tends to breathe a little bit more. If you stay in one color too long, it gets a bit redundant, a bit too predictable, and it's not as interesting. So if you switch around, you know, different colors, just spend a little bit of time in each idea. But you need to practice those legs, you know. But like, yeah, these diminished arpeggios can be cool. So there's a straight arpeggio, 1 flat 3 5 flat 7, but then kind of chromaticize, you can add a little augmented shift, augmented splash, I meant to say. Practice is slow. Okay, so, and just color shift, you know, go from diminished, a minor third, maybe then go, practicing these ideas. Of course, you're going to play them a longer period of time, but if you just come up with a simple jam, you know, minor seven, seven sharp, five sharp nine, and then you want to play over it. Maybe I'll try to find the link to that one video and slap it in this ad. But anyway, so you want color shifting, superimposing, you know, work on ideas that have color and then shift, go from like a minor 70 sounding thing to a major 7, to a diminished, to an augmented color, to a whole tone color. Practice a little, and then of course the importance of simple melodies are really powerful. All right, I'm going to stop right there. This guitar is available, $799. It really sounds good. These are undervalued guitars. I mean, they have kind of like an old Gibson L5 sound. These are really, really undervalued guitars. I've always loved these kind of things. This one's made in Korea. It's got the age binding. It's got a little spot right here. You know, any great guitar does, mostly, you know, but it's got really beautiful quilted back. The back is more of a richer burgundy. The top's not as rich. It's a little dusty right now. I've got the back pickup down low. It kind of brings the tone. Augmented. 7 sharp, 5 minor, 9 major, 9 augmented, 11. But yeah, this is a great guitar. Has a nice setup, plays really good, sounds really good. There's no case. Maybe we can work something out on a gig bag. I'll slay it at my cost. Minor major 7 would be this. I'm talking a bichord major 9 and minor 7 the same. To a major 13 flat 5. Bichord major 13 flat 5. Major 13. 7 sharp 5 sharp 9. 13 9. Folks, take care. You can order the guitar ladder system at stevesickguitars.com. It's only $199. It's thousands of dollars of info, 100 studies, chart and video. I don't send them all at once. It works. It'd be the best $199 you ever invest. My idea, you follow your hunch. Don't procrastinate your procrastination. If you want some real, you know, ear training and some real improvisation, we use the power of your subconscious mind, the science of neuroplasticity. It really works. You can email me, stevezook7@yahoo.com. That's the number 7, not spelled out. Or text me, 714-548-0385. Yeah, this guitar really sounds. And I'm using a solid state amp. It's just a solid state old PV. Paid a couple hundred bucks for. Diminished arpeggio to the diminished half step, whole step scale. But then I throw in that augmented splash. Alright, this is a bitchin' guitar. I don't really want to sell any of my guitars because most of my stuff is kind of really more. I work hard to cherry pick great guitars. You know, I don't just buy every guitar that somebody offers to me. And I really know guitars because I've been doing this since I was about 20 and I'm 68. So I really know the great guitars from the average. And people just don't seem to realize the great guitars are few and far between. It's not bullshit. Some guitars just have a lot more resonance, a lot more musicality, a lot more tone, a lot more vibe. So. All right, folks, take care. Bye-bye.